If you're like me, you probably proofread something a dozen times and still find mistakes later on. So in this video, I'm going to give you four tricks to help improve your accuracy in proofreading. The first is to read your work out loud. Second, use a ruler. Three, read backwards. And four, read for one problem at a time. So in this sample paper that I would be reading out loud, I would just go through it. In recent years, mental health and suicide have come to the forefront of rising health concerns in the United States. And by reading this out loud, what I'm doing is I'm forcing my brain to slow down and look at what is actually written on the page rather than what I believe is on the page. When we know what we mean to say, our brain tends to assume that that is what is actually on the page, and that's why we miss mistakes. For the second trick of using a ruler, you're going to take a sheet of paper and cover the screen and just read for one sentence at a time. So, what this does is, again, it sort of tricks your brain into only seeing what is actually on the page. Our eye tends to read ahead, so by blocking what comes ahead, it just helps us see what we actually put on the page. The third trick is to read backwards. Normally, I would go to the very bottom of the paper and work my way up, but for this example, I'm just going to start with the bottom of this paragraph. So I would read the last sentence, which says, "With the growing health crisis surrounding mental health and suicide, I do not believe that the church is doing enough to combat these issues within our congregations." And again, what this is doing is it's helping me isolate and focus on just what that sentence is saying without getting the context of the full paragraph. And if I find that there's no mistakes in that sentence and it makes sense, then I'll jump to the previous, that the sentence that comes right before it. So suicide is now the second leading. And this is a great method to use if you find yourself writing a lot of comma splices, fragments, or run-ons. So the last and fourth trick to use is to read for one problem at a time. And what this looks like is you might make a list for yourself. What are the three most common errors you always make in writing? They might be comma splices, fragments, or using you. And what you would do is read through the paper once, looking for comma splices. Then you would read through it again, looking for fragments. And the point of this is that our brains can only focus on so many things at once, and really just reading for one or two errors at a time is probably enough for your brain. Now, in that last example, I said using you, there is a way to use technology to help you proofread, and it's what professional editors do. So if you go to the find and replace feature in your document, this is Google Docs, you can use technology. You can also just do Control F. Now, you should not be used in academic writing. So if I type in you, it'll pull up all the yous in my paper. So right here we find one, and as I read through the sentence, "Suicide is now the leading cause of death among you people," I realize that I actually meant to type in young there. So this even helped me find a problem. But I still have a few other yous in the paper. So if I use the arrows, it'll help me find them. Now I notice these yous are within a quote, so I'm going to leave them in place. But if I needed to, I could just then retype and replace you with like he or she, or they, or whatever other word would be appropriate. So that's four tricks to help you with your proofreading and help you get more bang for your buck.